going to be doing another infinite series problem today. This one is an infinite decimal.
It's 0.21 repeating. That's what this line means. So that's the same thing as 0.21212121 ... forever.
That's what this represents. So they've given us this infinite decimal, and they've asked us to write it as a simple fraction, which means that we need to determine what value it converges to, or the sum of the series. And the formula that we use to determine this, and the formula we use for almost all infinite series problems, is the following. It's a three-part formula.
The first part is this right here. All this means is the sum of the series x to the k when the first value of k is 0 and the series goes on to infinity. The second part of the formula is the absolute value of x less than 1. If the absolute value of x is less than 1, this x here is less than 1, then the series converges. If it's greater than or equal to 1, it diverges, but that's where we stop. If it diverges, we're done. We say it diverges and we're done with it. If it converges, then we can find its sum, which we use 1 over 1 minus x to find. And again, these three x's here are the same in each case. So once we find this x, then we can apply it to these two parts of the formula. So the first thing we have to do with this series here is figure out whether or not it takes this form, if it can be represented by this form here, meaning x to the k. So the first thing we want to do is turn this decimal into a fraction. And the way that we would do that, we're going to take each part separately, like this. The first 0.21, right? Since this 1 is in the hundredths place, that's this first 0.21 here is the same thing as 21 over 100. So we'll write 21 over 100. And then this second one, this 1 is in the 10,000th place, so it would be 21 over 10,000, right? We just added two zeros here to this. Then the third 21 would be 21 over, whatever that one, and then 1, 2, 3, and then add two zeros. So that would be, yeah, the 1,000,000th place. And then we could go on forever. So that's the first step. We write it as a fraction. You always do it based on where the first section, whatever decimal place it ends in, this being the hundredths place, 10,000th place, 1,000,000th place, that's how you know what to put on the bottom here. So once you've done that, then you can factor the series. And the way that you want to do that is by taking out the first term here. You always want to just factor out the first term, whatever it is. So in this case, our first term is 21 over 100. So we want to say 21 over 100 times 1, right, for this term, plus 1 over, and that would be 100, right, because 4 zeros, yeah. So 1 over 100 times 21 over 100 is the same thing as 21 over 10,000 here. So we're just factoring the series. Then we have 1 over, and we'll have 4 zeros, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 1 over 10,000 plus dot, dot, dot. Okay, so we factored the series. That's the first important thing that we need to do. Second thing that we need to do now that the series is factored is determine, once we have the series like this, where you want to get to, the point you want to get to, is where you have the first term in your series equal to 1. You want the series to start with 1, which is why we factored out the 21 over 100. The,
the sole purpose of taking this 21 over 100 out is so that we could get the series to start with 1. Because once the series starts with 1, we then know, almost certainly, that this second term right here, the term immediately following the 1, is our x term here, is equal to x. The way that we know that, the way that we can double check it, and that we can prove that we're right, if we expand this series here, the way this series is actually written out, if we expand it, is the following. X to the 0, right, because the first value of k is 0, so the first exponent on the x is 0, and then since it goes on into infinity, it's plus x to the 1, plus x to the 2, plus x to the 3, plus dot, dot, dot. That's what this series here looks like when we expand it. So, you can see if we simplify this, anything raised to the 0 power, no matter what it is equal to 1. So x to the 0 is the same thing as 1, is equal to 1. X to the 1, right, that's redundant. We never write anything to the 1 power, to the power of 1. That's x. So we have 1 plus x squared, plus x cubed, plus dot, dot, dot. So we've simplified the series. So you can see here, right, when we get the series to start with 1, it most closely approximates this series, right? Because we have the 1 here being the first term, and then the reason I'm saying this is x, right, is because the second term here is x. So we're hoping that this is x. This would, of course, then be x squared. The next term would be x cubed. So that's why we factor this, so that we can get the series to start with 1, because then whatever this term is most likely x. So let's go ahead and just double check. If x is 1 over 100, then our series, we're just going to go ahead and apply it here. Our series is 1 plus 1 over 100 plus 1 over 100 squared. And this is actually, 1 over 100, and this whole thing would be squared, right? Because the whole x is squared. So then plus 1 over 100 cubed plus dot, dot, dot. Okay, so that would be, if 1 over 100 is our x, then that's what the series would look like. So what we need to do is make sure that this series is the same thing as this series here. And we have the 1, and we have the 1 over 100. So the question is 1 over 100 squared the same as 1 over 10,000? And in fact, it is, right? 1 over 100 squared would be 1 over 1 with 4 zeros, which is 10,000. 1 over 10,000. So the series is matching up. We can see that they're going to end up being the same series. So we've proven, we went on 1 over 100 being our x term as a hunch, because when you have the series starting with 1, that second term is almost always your x. But we double checked by plugging 1 over 100 back into this series right here to make sure that this was matching this. So 1 over 100 is our x term. Make sure when you have a series like this and you have to factor out the first term to get this series, that you don't forget about this term, because your answer will absolutely be wrong if you forget about it. So you have the 21 over 100, and then 1 over 100 is your x. So the way that we write that, our series, this infinite decimal, can be represented like the following. Since we have 21 over 100 multiplied by the whole series, we have 21 over 100 multiplied by the whole series. The series represented, of course, remember we said our x was 1 over 100? So we plug 1 over 100 in here for x and keep everything else. And we have now rewritten this infinite decimal in this form, so that this infinite decimal is written in the form of this formula here, this the formula, and we know what our x is, so that we can determine the sum and find out whether or not it converges. So if our x is 1 over 100, now we need to plug that in here. The absolute value of 1 over 100 is less than 1. We need to find out if it is or not. Absolute value just means take the positive value of whatever's on the inside here. So if this were negative 1 over 100, you would take the positive value, so you would just take away that negative sign, and it would be 1 over 100. Since our value is already positive, we don't really need to worry about it, and the absolute value brackets really have no effect. So our question is 1 over 100 less than 1? And of course we know that it is. So since this is less than 1, our series does converge. So series does converge, converges. And then, since it does converge, we need to find the sum using this formula right here, 1 over 1 minus x. Since our x is 1 over 100, we go ahead and say 1 over 1 minus 1 over 100. But we can't forget, do not forget about our 21 over 100. Since that is multiplied by the whole series, we have to multiply it out in front here. Okay? So now let's go ahead and simplify this. The first thing I'm going to do is make this 100 over 100 so that I can write 100 over 100 is the same thing as 1. But I want to simplify this denominator here, and I need common denominators, this 100 and 100, to match so that I can simplify. So I'll have 21 over 100 times 1 over 100 minus 1 is 99 in the numerator, and then of course since I have 100 on the bottom of both fractions, I can combine those two. And then I have 1 divided by a fraction. Whenever I have something divided by a fraction, instead of dividing here, I can multiply by the inverse. So this 1 over 99 one-hundredths is the same thing as, we'll go ahead and write 21 over 100, is the same thing as 1 times 100 over 99. I flipped this fraction upside down and multiplied these two together instead of dividing, which is a common algebraic operation that you should definitely get comfortable with. So now we've got 1 times 100 over 99, which of course is just the same thing as 100 over 99. So now we have these two fractions multiplied together. You can see we have a 100 on the bottom and a 100 on the top, which means those two cancel. And we're left with 21 over 99. So that is our final answer. The series converges to 21 over 99. 21 over 99 is the sum of the series, and the answer we would write down is converges to 21 over 99. Thanks, guys. See you next time.